Irreverent adult humour.
Kid, sort of obsessed with them, really wanted gerbils, really wanted gerbils. I got one, it was called Barney, right? Lovely, manly, blokey name, Barney the gerbil. Then Barney, after about a day, with scant regard for his gender, just done a big load of babies out of his vagina. About 10. And the first generation of them, it was really beautiful. Second generation went all barbaric and nasty, because what happened, right? Barney begat about 10. Them lot start begat a lot of others, right? The ones what begat each other start to eat each other's babies for a laugh, as far as I could work out. I don't know, guilt or sense of contrition about what I was doing. Yeah, what? Yeah, I'm eating one of my nephews. Sorry, a moment on the lips, a lifetime on the hips. What was I thinking? Right, I'm angry about it at first because I thought, that's not what we agreed for our utopia. But then I'd look down at their little faces and I'll think, how can I stay mad at you, you murderous, incestuous, infanticidal, cannibal little slags? In spite of my difficulties with pets, I was a better pet owner than this bloke, right? He's got himself a big, bloody, great, proper James Earl Jones-style Lion King thing in his house in England, and he sort of deals with it like it's like a wayward, troublesome teenager, right? He's like a football manager of a lion Gazza. Like how they would go, oh, you know, Paul, he's lovely, but you got to, you know, you got to look after Gazza. And then Gazza would turn up, ah! Oh, there he goes, he's making a face behind me head, like, ah! Like he's trying to manage a lion. He's a lion!
What do you call him?
Khan.
Does he like, I mean, is he quite happy just sitting there while you're with him?
Oh, are you? He loves me a beer, doesn't he? What, can you see that noise? Give us a kiss. Hey, give us a kiss, Dean. Give me a kiss, hey?
Is he dangerous?
Huh?
Isn't it dangerous to have an animal like that as a pet, though?
Well, it all depends, like, you know, if you treat them with kindness, you can see how much he's dangerous.
Could he ever turn on you? I mean, he looks very friendly there.
Well, he could do, yes, of course he could.
But, I mean, there would be any particular reason for him to...
Yeah.
Very playful, isn't he?
Yeah. Get off.
Back it in! Oh! Stop it, you pillock! Trying to kill him! What would he do differently if that lion were trying to kill... Oh, get off! Ow! Wind your neck in, you prat! This woman, right, she probably loves her horse, Irene, she reckons her name is, I ain't seen no evidence of it. She really loves her horse, but she's got the attitude towards it of a battered wife. No, I know he loves me, I know he loves me. After he hits me, he always cries and says, sorry, I think it's my fault, I think I make him hit me. And why does his horse always kick her head in on Christian festivals?
I had an awful lot of time off work through falls, and I spent no end of time going to a physiotherapist at sleep and being patched up. Last Christmas I went to play at Clipsham Church and I was in such a crippled up position I went for communion. I couldn't even get from my knees at the altar rails. They had to pull me up. And I still got on and rode, didn't I, lovebird? Still go back for more. I fell off her on Easter Sunday and it knocked me out. I climbed on again and rode home. And then she threw me again Easter Monday, and I still got that from you. Thank you, darling.
He loves me! On pancake day, he glassed me in the face. That horse is a fundamentalist Christian. I will kill before another Ash Wednesday goes unobserved. Look at these posh women talking about their dog. Right, he's a little, lovely, lonely, idiot cartoon dog with a lovely set of gnashers all grinning. They're talking about him like he's sort of from Wuthering Heights or something. Oh, he's complicated. What makes him tick, the little bastard?
I don't know what it is with this dog.
Elvis Presley way that he sort of goes into it, like, and like he's constantly trying to repress all this anger that he's sitting on. He's kind of a canine Rain Man figure. Could be sort of normal for a bit. Fuck you! I just can't suppress it. Like, you bastard!
And if he sees your shadow at the door, as you know sometimes...
Yeah.
Goes for you, doesn't he?
Well, I don't know why he does. I'm a great lover of animals. Goodness,
yes, I know, but that's not the point.
I think it's jealousy.
I don't think it is. I think it's either jealousy.
Jealousy, I think it is.
Or he doesn't take to elderly people.
Well, I don't know what to do. Well, they do. Be careful.
Oh, he's all embarrassed. After he does it, he's sort of, sorry about that. Wags his tail. I'm ever so embarrassed. Sorry, like he's done a little fart. Oh, sorry. Sorry, one of them people you see in the street, like, fuck you! Sorry, sorry. I don't know why I did that. I do apologise. Look at this, right? This information is presented to us as if it's a loopy balmy, just have a little bit of fun, cat up a tree style news item. You know when at the end of the news they go, okay, that was a terrible murder. Meanwhile, a cat's been caught up a tree, right? They try and present it to us like that, but there's also twisted macabre undertones.
An enraged pet shop customer was today sentenced to a year's probation for stamping a budgie to death in a pet shop after she'd been given it as a peace offering in a dispute about the purchase of a dog.
A woman was arrested after she stamped on a budgie which was given to her as a peace offering in a dispute about a dog? What a world are we living in? This crazy animal hitman bartering loony system. Sorry, what, you don't like the dog? Nah. Would you like this budgie? No! Why would you ever offer a budgie for a dog? The dog was offered as a peace offering in a row about a dolphin, which had originally been handed over because she didn't like a lizard, and this stretches back to a quarrel that Jesus had about a woolly mammoth.